film him and then film me.
Welcome everybody. Merry holidays. This is my Christmas special. We're gonna have a lot of fun today. I'm gonna have my friends and lower the volume. Lower, stop. You're too loud. Softly. Play little jingle bells now, like something like that, like real softly. So all right, yeah. So welcome, glad y'all are here. Hope you guys have some nice hot cocoa and gingerbread men cookies. I just want to say big thanks to our sponsor, Performance Transportation and Logistics. If you ever need a truck or something, I'll call me. You call me, I'll call my dad. And if you need a truck, I might get commission. So that'd be real cool because I'm in dire need of money right now. And there he is, a Performance Transportation and Logistics himself, here playing some music. You're rolling? Mm-hmm. All right, happy holidays. I'm going to show you guys how to shop for gifts. I'm a professional at it. I'm going to give you some tips along the way. I'm going to get some gifts for some people that I know. First stop, you get the sign, Goodwill. All right, as you can see, looking very stylish right now. I got the boots on, got the jeans, and I'm looking comfortable. It's like what those football players say. Look good, feel good, play good. Now time to shop. So when you're shopping for people, you gotta think about the four number one rules of shopping for people. One, you gotta make sure it's a surprise. They don't know about it. Number one, surprise. Number two, you gotta make sure you're paying good money for it. No theft. Don't steal. Number three, yaks like summer and walks like rain. Number four, festive. So think about that for sure. Maybe it's not festive, maybe it is, but make sure you get the gift for the person that's on your list. So if you're getting a gift for your mom, don't get the gift for your Uncle Larry. One person I'm shopping for is my buddy Eli. He's kind of like a kid, so I was looking in the kids section, but I didn't really see anything good. Got a couple of coats. I don't know how he is with the coat game. Not like me, always on that drip. That's what they say, right? Drip, something like that. Getting kids into golf. Now, I think it'd be a good gift for him because he's not really into golf, but if I wanted to like fabricate what my friends did as hobbies, this would be a real good start getting him into golf. $6.99 seems like a lot. I don't know if I can afford that in this year's budget, real tight economy. I'm just making videos for free, really, so if anybody wanted to load me up with cash. This could be a good addition because we got, this could be a great addition because we got the whole golf set. I'm a lefty, but this might work for him. I don't know if he's lefty or righty or not, but it might be good. We got a bundle of gifts together, that's a good idea, but again, I don't like it more. Classic flowers, architecture, you know, real good art stuff. Oh, and there he is. We got him. It's the Pontiff. This works, doubles as an art gift or a festive religious gift. Because, as you all know, the Pontiff of Christmas, you know, the whole deal.
So yeah, you like Christmas, right?
I like Christmas.
Cool. Yeah, so now we have a real good special guest, my friend Seth. Seth, why don't you come on out? You just happen to be here. Seth in the building. You're not infested here. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, yeah, hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Yeah, jingle bells, and jingle bells, and wrap it up, we're at a time limit. Okay, yeah. Hey, thanks, that was great. Glad you could make it and sing a song. Ryan from Playground Rules, you guys all know him, Ryan from Playground Rules. He's going to show us a little video, another special edition holiday episode of Playground Rules. Roll it.
Hey, hey kids. Today, I'm Ryan W., and I'm saying no thanks. Thanksgiving. Because this is the special edition, Playground Rules, winter edition. So get your sleigh bells jingling. Get your dasher going. Your prancer ready. Because we got rules to play. The first thing I've been asked to talk about in winter playground rules is what?
Winter safety.
Winter safety rules. I can't say the P word anymore. But is that black ice is really dangerous, and there's not a lot here, but you know, I could just do like a little simulation for you. It's probably gonna look a little like this. Well, don't make your own black ice. Don't make black ice at home. This is for educational purposes. Something like that. If you're seeing that on your walk to school, I'm gonna have to recommend that you don't step in that, because you're probably gonna slip like that. And you know what happens if you do that three times? You're gonna hurt your back or something worse, probably. But so don't. Number one. No black ice. And the second rule I've been asked to discuss is bundle up, which I did not follow. I just took off my coat and it's really chilly out. But gloves. You know, you want to stay warm, put on gloves. For our next rule, making snowballs. For snowballs, you're going to want to get some good snow here. It's really cold. I think I have a glove. The glove doesn't help when your hands are already wet, but a good snowball starts with snow. Preferably if you have two hands, I would use both of them. And you just pack it up tight, kind of like that, and you're ready to toss it at Randy, Bobby, Billy, but don't throw it at their heads. I lost a lot of friends to headshots at snowball fights, and I lost a lot of detention recess time for doing that. So please aim for the guts, no limbs, no heads. So just keep it safe out there. So
yeah.
That's all the time I got for winter safety play rules. I'm gonna head back to the studio. Merry Christmas. And I just want to make sure all the kids are safe out there, like you saw. So, you know, I think the video speaks for itself.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, you said don't slip on ice, and you slipped on ice at the end. Okay, yeah, so someone offstage just told me that we have a video sent in, I guess from someone I know. Someone made a festive holiday video. We'll get that up here. Even sent that in? Who made this?
Hey, I'm your friend Dylan, as you know. I just thought I'd make that little video. I thought you'd like that. I knew you were making the special, and so.
One of the most offensive things I've seen, like, that's holiday related. That's ridiculous. This is a live show. Like, this is like a completely live show, and. You're just gonna come in and make this stupid. I don't even know why I put it up. I don't even know why it's. I'm just running low on content at this point. How's your holidays treating you?
I'm doing great, actually.
Yeah.
All
right. Cool.
Yeah. I just I really like all the stuff that I put in there. I didn't know if you had any questions. It's a layered video. And listicles are very popular right now. I'm trying to get in with BuzzFeed right now, so I thought that'd be a good resume builder. So I'm just kind of, you know, ride these coattails, get a boost my content out there. But you know, I put on the sweater at least, kind of minimal effort to at least put on a good show for these people, whoever you got watching. So I don't know, you know, how's it going?
I just want to spread some holiday cheer for everybody. Got you a gift?
Oh, yeah.
Here we go.
Drats. Can the band see what it says? It
smells like vinegar.
Hey, it's a big dog. I am...
Is that me? Is that what you think of me?
You know, I know who let the dogs out. It's in D flat.
That's your gift, Merry.
It's not really festive.
Merry Christmas.
They made this in 2007. They've been selling this for 11 years.
Really?
Yeah.
That's impressive, honestly. All right. Well, thanks for coming on the show. Enjoy your gift.
All right.
And there you have it. That's a.
That's really white.
A gift for you.
Yeah.
Thanks.
All right. Yeah. No. Get out. Because we're about to do. You ready, audience, for this? Get out. Get out of here. We're about to do a live in studio Skype call with my friend Eli, who's not here, thank God, to talk to us in person. But he's here. Gonna do a little Skype call, and we're gonna chat about movies. So let's get this pulled up here on Skype.
Hey, Anthony, coming to you live from Hofstra University. Sorry I couldn't make it to your good old live-fashioned Christmas special, But a big boy likes me.
He says he's at school, but that looks like it's in his house.
So I gotta sneak in a little live message brought to you through the power of Skype, sponsored by Microsoft, to give you this little holiday message of cheer. Because I know you love so many movies, I picked out a great selection for the Christmas holiday. Gifts for everybody and movies that are pretty good for the holiday season. So, what do you say on our live phone call? How about I give you a gift of joy? Live! A holiday tradition, Anthony. A live version of a classic holiday tradition. Let's go! Live! On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Spider-Man Homecoming.
Eli, you there? Can you hear me? Eli, this is Skype. My true love, your friend Ant on Skype.
Yogi Bear and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Genie, Yogi Bear and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me the Pasta DVD. Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Dwabo Politics 1 and 2, the Pasta DVD, Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love gave to me the Puppy Bowl 3 on homemade recorded VHS. Dwabo Politics, the past, the DVD.
How long is this going to go for?
Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Eggy Sack Solo, Puppy Bowl 3, Dwabo Politics, the past on DVD. Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear.
The pest is all, he's Spider-Man choosing all these awful movies.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Baby Flicks, Eggy Sack Solo, Puppy Bowl 3, Dwabo Politics, The Pest on DVD. Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming.
Best is a classic.
On the 10th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Donkey Ollie, Baby Flicks, Eggy Sack Solo, Puppy Bowl 3, Dwabo Politics, The Past on DVD. Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the 11th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Wallace and...
What is this, a pre-recorded video? He's not even, like, Donkey Eli.
Baby Flicks, Eggy Sack Solo, Puppy Bowl 3, Dwabo Politics, The Pest... Plan B, Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Fight Club on PS2. Wallace and Gromit, Donkey, Ollie, Baby Flicks, Eddie Sack Solo, Puppy Bowl 3, Dwabo Politics, The Past on DVD.
I don't even know what Donkey Ollie is.
Geely, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. On the 13th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, Fight Club on PS2.
That's a PlayStation Wallace game. It's not even the movie Fight Club.
Donkey, Ollie, Baby Flicks.
Was it Baby Sex? So. Fuck is he doing? Eli. Eli.
Puppy Bowl 3, Trouble Politics, The Past on DVD. Plan B, Gilly, Yogi Bear, and Spider-Man Homecoming. I hope you enjoyed all these movies, Aunt. And I got one last little surprise for you. This live recording is actually just a recording. And I'm coming to your live Christmas special right now. I'm at your front door, Aunt. Answer!
Watch it, don't fucking knock over my shit. What are you doing? That wasn't even... Jesus Christ.
Drop it in.
Happy Christmas, Aunt! You thought I was in Hofstra.
Fuck. Ow, shit. Jingle Bell Rock or something. It's too late.
I know it's a big surprise, but I got this shirt on. It says...
Can you read it? Half of those weren't even movies.
Well, they're all Christmas themed. And I know your reaction to one of them, so I brought it on set for us. My home recorded VHS of the Puppy Bowl 3. We could watch that, and we could talk about...
We don't even have a VHS player. Well, I mean... VCR, whatever it's called.
You could just... You have a VCR player. I mean, no. Everyone's got a VCR player.
I don't.
How are you going to watch The Grinch Stole Christmas?
Blu-ray, like everyone else.
What's that?
YouTube.com.
Well, then, we got this
Grinch
right here.
Grinch Stole Christmas.
Well, then, it's clearly not a Christmas special if you don't have a VCR player. Well, I made a list, a lot of good movies. You should check them all out, especially The Pest. It's a good Christmas story about racism and social class in America. There's a pretty catchy opening song.
Leave. Get out. Yeah, get out. You're going to keep getting calls.
You get my pill.
Yeah, they're that's our sponsor. Performance Transportation, everybody, our sponsor of the show. Thanks. Yeah.
Is that your dad or is that your
son? He's the musical guest. He's
Will is he your father?
Yeah, it's my dad.
Well, why don't you get a real musical guest?
He's fucking good at harmonica, dude.
You want me to come back and do music? Or I can, I'm still here. I'm just.
Is that scary to do?
We gotta wrap it up. I don't even know how we are in time. At this point, it doesn't really matter. This is all one big joke. All right, so we're gonna give out some awards tonight. First award is Skater of the Year. Skater of the Year award goes to all my fucking boys, but mostly the Bresh. Shout out to the Bresh. This one's for you. Now that she's back
in the Jonah Hill, mid-90s. That's
stop. Okay, next award. This one goes to, this is NFL related. Best football throw of the year. That goes to Chad Farco back in 2015.
That's the money calling. Out here getting ready for anything, boy.
That's this year.
Well, I reposted it this year.
It's still the best throw of the year.
It's the best throw of the year because you know about it this year. So, next award. This one was for you, Chad Farco. This one's for the girls. This award is the Prince Shaman Vice Lord of New Britain New Britainer, honorary New Britainer of the Year award. This one goes to Matt Albino's hat, the hat on his head, Hat Albino. Check it out.
But tell me, did the wind sweep you off your feet? Did you finally get the chance to dance along the light of day?
Can I see that?
Thor, dude.
Yeah, you want to hear this for a second?
What?
It's pretty tight.
Marvel Studios' Black Panther follows T'Challa, who, after the death of his father, the King of Wakanda, returns home to the isolated, technologically advanced African nation to succeed to the throne and take his rightful place as king. But when a powerful old enemy reappears, T'Challa's mettle as king and Black Panther is tested when he is drawn into a formidable conflict that puts the fate of Wakanda and the entire world at risk. Faced with treachery and danger, the young king must rally his allies and release the full power of Black Panther to defeat his foes and secure the safety of his people and their way of life.
Michael B. Jordan was in that too. He's good.
He's a Baby Creed.
I don't think that was his name.
That's the character's name.
Michael Jordan Jr. Yeah.
I
thought you were talking about Michael Peterson. What?
No one gets your jokes.
The alt-right guy.
Who? Anyways, this diorama of Black Panther is based on his appearance in the feature film Marvel's Black Panther. It is made of high-quality PVC, like the piping, and features collectible quality paint applications. Quality.
I saw the Blue Man Group in Boston one time, and they played songs on PVC pipes. They turned them into drums and stuff. They were flinging paint around and shooting marshmallows around. They had a lady come up, and she had a thing on, and I think she got blued on.
Nice.
You could have bought the painting after the show, but I didn't do that because, you know, the experience is enough. So just think about that. Back to you.
Sure.
He had like a little Marvel cape.
Mm.
Yeah, I'm not going to film that. So. Anthony, what are you looking forward to this holiday season?
The Christmas special.
I want to look forward to that.
I'd do something a bit more realistic. You got any meal plans?
Yeah, meal planning.
I
just got a rice cooker.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks everyone for watching my Christmas special this year. I hope you all enjoyed it. Glad I could spread some holiday cheer. Please like, comment, and subscribe on this. Hope you all enjoy it and have a great Christmas and the rest of your holidays and everything else too. I think we did a really good job, and I'll see you in 2019.